What are private files? Every user in Moodle has a personal file storage area known as private files. This is useful as a teacher if you like to organize your files into named folders and upload them privately until you want to display them on your course. It's also useful for students if they start work on something, save their work in their private files, complete it and submit it later. Private files can be accessed from your user menu. And there's also a private files block which may be added to a course page by a teacher. If we click private files, we can see what it looks like. We can, if the browser allows, simply drag a file to the private files area. We could click add and add from the file picker, or we can create a folder and upload files into there. So let's create a folder called vocabulary, and then when we click to create the folder, we can then click into it and upload straight into this folder. I'm going to click the Add button and go to Moodle's File Picker, which we explore in a separate video, then choose the files to add to the Private Files Vocabulary folder. We can change its name if we want, change the author if we want, change the license from the site default if needed, remembering this is not shown on the course page, and then when we click Upload this file, it's important to remember to save the changes. Private Files now has a folder with the files in which we can access at a later date to display on our course. If we want to display one of these files on the course page, we can choose to link to it instead of making a copy. This means that if the file is changed and re-uploaded to Private Files, then the file is also changed in any course where it's been uploaded. And finally, if your administrator allows it, you can send files to your private files as email attachments. If you're able to do this on your Moodle site, you'll see an email address in the private files area, and this is the address that you use to email private files.